One of the challenges with any powerful drag car is getting the car to reliably go down the track time and time again, and a lot of this comes down to the drivetrain configuration. We see a lot of different options, from automatic transmissions to clutchless transmissions. We also see conventional style clutches and slider type adjustable clutches. Each has their pros and cons, and we're here with Nate from 99 Racing to talk a little bit about the combination they're running in this Toyota Camry powered by a 2J Z behind me. Before we get into the transmission here, Nate, let's give us some details, some facts and figures about the car. What sort of ET and mile an hour are you running at the moment?
So we've gone 629 at 225 on a relatively soft boost level, around 60 pound. That was with the old turbo. Since then we've gone to a Garrett Gen 2 106 mil, so we're expecting a few upgrades in the time slips, I think.
Now, for those viewing, you just said 60 pound and mentioned relatively soft, so a few people might be thinking that sounds like a lot of boost. We need to keep some perspective here. A lot of the contenders running in the 5 second bracket with the 2JZ, we're talking triple figures, like 100 PSI there or thereabouts. So as you say, still a relatively low power, low boost level. And have you got some idea on what sort of power you're producing at that sort of boost level?
At the hubs, I think we're around the 2200 horsepower, so about 2400 flywheel, but we don't put it on hub dynos. It doesn't give a correct reading, especially if running an auto with a torque converter, so it tends to just drive through it.
All right, so that brings us on to the segue into the next section, which is quite timely, is the transmission. You've just mentioned you've got an auto in there. And I think it's fair to say that the fastest 2JZs out there at the moment running in the 5 second bracket, as far as I'm aware, almost exclusively are running clutchless style transmissions or maybe Lencos. The downside with this is running a clutch style transmission makes it very hard to tune the car and get consistency run to run. So the converter, on the other hand, with the auto, where do you see the advantages there?
We can dial the auto in a lot more, I could say a lot easier than a clutch. So if we get a bad track from day to day or week to week or run to run, we can just play around with the RPM settings or boost levels. We just pull a few pound on the hip on the two-step and just run a little bit lower boost. If we want to keep that boost, we just pull the RPM level down.
So again, for those who are viewing who maybe aren't familiar with a clutch, I just want to get into that just very briefly. So an adjustable clutch that's common in drag racing is adjustable for both the base pressure as well as the centrifugal weight. So it essentially forces the clutch to slip in a controlled manner off the start line. When you get it right, it's perfect, it's great, but getting it right is the problem. So the converter, much more consistent run to run?
Yeah, it can be much more user friendly. If we do have issues, we do have a bolt together converter, so we can play around with stators, so it'll give us more slip or tighten up the converter as we need to, as we race to race or meet to meet, I guess.
Okay, I want to come back to the converter because that's the key to particularly the 60 foot. But once you actually got the car past the 60 foot with the shifts with your automatic transmission, are there advantages to the way that shift progresses in order to keep the car hooked up compared to a clutchless manual, or are they much the same?
Much the same, but we have the advantage. We do run a dump valve on our gearbox, which can dump gearbox pressure as well as converter pressure. So with through the Motec, we can program that in to at a specific RPM or a specific boost setting to dump the transmission fluid for a point of a second or more than that, and that will allow the box to slip and allow us to pull the RPM up.
So using that dump valve, you've essentially got a computer controlled slippable clutch, for want of a better term?
Yeah, you could say that, yes.
Now, coming back to the converter, because as I mentioned, this is sort of the key to getting the car to leave properly. And you mentioned you've got the ability to change the stators with that bolt together converter to adjust essentially how tight it is. And one of the problems with a small capacity turbocharged engine is actually building enough or creating enough torque to bring the car up onto the two-step with a converter versus a clutch. So can you talk to us about how you're doing that?
So at the moment, we got the dump valves, like I just mentioned. So we open them up at a very low RPM, say around 3,000 RPM. And then we also have nitrous kicking at about the same time. That allows the boost levels to spool up and the RPM to come up. And then as we start coming up into the RPM range, we also run a retard through the timing, which allows the turbo to start spooling up.
Okay, so initially dumping the fluid out of the converter essentially allows it to slip, so that allows the RPM to build quickly, and then once the RPM's up, you've got boost pressure there, the engine's then making enough torque to drive the converter so you can refill it.
You can basically see it, if you've got a converter that's empty and try and spin it in a gearbox, it spins quite freely. You put a lot of fluid in there, it gets heavy, spins quite heavily. So once we dump that fluid, get it out of the converter's able to free up and able to come up through through the RPM range a lot easier.
Now, once you actually leave the line, you can still actually play with that dump valve to control the converter a little bit as well if you need a little bit of additional slip. Can you talk us through how that works?
So depending on the track conditions, if we've got a really tight track and we're struggling to get the car out of the hole and it's rattling, so we can pulse that dump valve to stay open for a certain amount of time so we can pull through, basically in essence slipping the clutch or slipping a converter in our
So you've basically got the ability to create a controlled amount of slip through the converter, so just as you say, like a slipping clutch.
Yeah, that's correct, yes.
Now, one of the downsides of the automatic transmission is generally we see for a given amount of engine power, they will show potentially less mile an hour at the end of the track, and this is due to the converter slip. So no matter what you're doing really with a conventional converter, there will be some amount of slip. Can you talk to us about how that works?
Yes, we're always going to get some slip with a traditional type of converter. But we also able to run lockup converters. A lot of pro mod guys are running them in at the moment, the radial versus world cars. So you're able to lock that converter up and basically able to mile an hour at the same time. We are not running a lockup at the moment. It is something we are considering, but at the moment we feel that we don't need to.
So the lockup converter, from what I understand, runs essentially a clutch that can be locked up once the car's maybe past the 60 foot or once you've actually got out of the hole, and then you're kind of getting the best of both worlds, the same lockup, one-to-one drive as a manual clutch, but you've got the converter to get out of the hole easier?
Yeah, that's pretty much correct. But it also does put a lot of load on your engine, so it does create a lot of wear and tear on the components around your gearbox, which can also break things. So you've got to be wary of that side of things.
I guess it's fair to say that there's no perfect solution here, and every option has its pros and cons, but great to get some insight into what goes into a modern converter and automatic transmission. Thanks for your time, and hopefully if the weather clears up today, you might get to have a crack at going a bit quicker than the 629.
Hopefully we do. We've got some big things, a lot of changes in the car recently, so yeah, hopefully this weather clears up and we get out on the track very soon.
All the best.
Thank you.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.